We are in Vietnam. This is day two. And you guys, my sleep quality has never been better. And I use this app to track my sleep, and they track your REM cycles. If you snored, they even like record your snoring, and they tell you if you like talked in your sleep and everything. And like, I usually get like 60 to 80% sleep quality. I have never gotten 100% 2 days in a row. So Vietnam is somehow making my sleep quality much better. This is my first time eating mango sticky rice, and I have absolutely no idea how to eat it. I put the sauce on the side because I thought it was going to be really sweet, and I don't like sweet things, but I do like mango. It was all right. I also got the green mango salad that I didn't like yesterday because today it looked a little bit better. And of course I ate pho for breakfast. I told you guys I'm gonna eat pho every single day while I'm in Vietnam. And then we got back to our room and got ready to go on a private tour of the Marble Mountains and the Monkey Mountains. I did absolutely zero research. I just know that I have to bring toilet paper because I learned that yesterday. And look at this. Tell me that this is not poop art. Like, it's placed in my toilet. This has to be a joke. Like, I know for a fact someone went like, oh my god, let's put like a random poop art on top of the toilet so people can like poop under the poop. Anyways, I should stop saying poop because my son's friends sometimes watch my vlogs. So anyways, this amazing person is our tour guide, and his name is Sunny. He is the best tour guide in Da Nang. We don't know any other tour guide in Da Nang, but I swear to god, he is the best. So first he took us to the Marble Mountains, which was very close to our hotel. We three had absolutely zero idea what we were going to be seeing. Here we are being greeted by a demon hand sticking out of the water. Sunny is casually bringing us through the entrance of the cave. There are these gigantic creepy candles, and inside it gets even more creepier. And he proceeds to explain to us who this gentleman is who is stuck on the wall. And then he told me that I look like an influencer, and mind you, he does not have TikTok, he does not have Instagram. He was just joking that with my pink hair I could be an influencer. And then he just kept going and said that we're gonna be entering hell. I thought that was some kind of Vietnamese joke. It wasn't. We were actually going into hell. And then he told us to not worry because in Asian hell, you don't have to stay there. You can get out of there. And by the way, this gentleman who looks like Licky Tongue, if you know, is the doorman to hell. So we are welcomed in and we see this. I have no idea what I'm looking at. And then there is a recording of chanting playing in the background. This right here is the scale of karma. And Sunny explained to us that whatever you do comes back karma, but it comes back with 5% interest. So essentially what comes back to you is 5% more than what you gave out, just like a bank loan. So we prayed. We prayed that we would get out of here alive. I think I should have done some research on where I would be touring. This is literally in Japanese. It says gate to hell. Here are the people getting punished. Some of them are just being fried in the pot like fried chicken. Sunny was just explaining everything that was just going on. I can't really say it on TikTok because my video might get taken down. Horrible things. Anyways, we go down. I don't know how much we went down, but looking at the concept of everything, yeah, of course we're going down. Just a warning, if you have bad knees or you don't want to be walking on like unstable surfaces going down a cave, this might not be a good place to visit. And also, if you don't like to see the details of what happens in hell, maybe this is not the best place for you. And then Sunny told us that these are the judges for Vietnam's Got Talent. Honestly, a lot of the things that I saw were shocking and confusing, and I really think that they should do a major rebranding of the name of this place. I can't think of a good one on the spot, but if you can think of a good one, write it in the comments. So anyways, we came back to the human world. It was beautiful. And here you are seeing the mountains of five elements. Since I did absolutely no research, if it weren't for Sunny being so fun and comical, the first part of this tour would have been so weird and so awkward, getting a tour of Vietnamese hell. Anyways, the dogs were taking a nap and they were adorable. And this is actually what I had in mind when I thought of like doing a tour of the mountains. I thought there would be like nice temples like this, Buddha statues and trees and, you know, this kind of stuff. But Sunny, he knew the place inside out. He was very efficient too. He would guide us to the important places and then explain it to us. And the most amazing thing is that he seems like he's having a lot of fun doing it. Like, I know this is his job and he's done this tour like hundreds of times before, but the way he explained it and his overall vibe was so nice. If you are ever gonna go to Da Nang, I will personally give you his number. But let me warn you, if you are even remotely, just even slightly rude or mean to Sunny, I will personally seek revenge for him, and you have no idea what ideas I got from the cave that I just visited, okay? Anyways, we had to take a few breaks because the steps were so steep. Yamato's in cross country, so it was nothing to him. But I had to rest, so we decided to teach Sunny some Japanese. And it turns out that Sunny's name actually means Japan. By the way, this is my son's kanji test prep sheet, and I have no idea why he had it in his backpack. But yeah, we taught him Japanese. And then we proceeded to go into another cave. And apparently this cave has this good luck for having more babies. So I politely declined the offer and went out. And then Sunny showed us some art that was made out of Heineken bottles. I'm not joking. It's actually made out of Heineken bottles. For real. Anyways, going down the stairs that were made hundreds of years ago was absolutely not fun. I was so unstable. I actually had an injured knee, but I didn't want to make excuses. So I pretended I was fine. And then we took a bathroom stop at this marble shop, okay? And as you have guessed, yes, after the bathroom break, there will be a lady come up to you and she is going to show you around the whole shop. And this is how most tour guide companies work. They work together with local vendors. They bring in the customers and, you know, you look at the stuff. This happens a lot in Southeast Asia, and a lot of people don't like the fact that they're kind of being pushed to look at things they don't really want to buy. By the way, for reference, this pot is about like $3,000. Anyways, I personally don't think it's that bad. These people are making a living. And if you don't want to buy it, all you have to do is politely say no thank you. So we did just that. And then we went to the Monkey Mountains. Unlike Marble Mountain, this was exactly what we expected, and we were greeted by little monkeys. I was a little bit worried that they were going to be aggressive, so I really kept my distance, but Sunny told us that if you don't have food, they won't be aggressive at all. So I waved at them, and I thought one of them waved back, but they were just scratching himself. And then more and more monkeys started to come out because they all thought that we had food, so they were kind of like waiting, and I felt so bad because we're not supposed to give food. So we took some pictures, and then we went all the way to the top where there's this creepy statue. This actually also exists in Japan. This is the don't look, don't hear, don't talk monkeys. I'm not gonna explain it. I'm just too lazy. And then we saw a random pig, and then the pig knocked down this bowl, and the dogs kept like barking at the pig. All of this was very random. And then we went to see the lady Buddha. But before that, Sunny taught us that these Japanese water lily leaves are completely waterproof and they don't get dirty at all. And in my 35 years of living in Japan, I never knew this. I am learning so much on this trip, thanks to Sunny. And then we ended the trip having lunch at a local Vietnamese restaurant. We had it Vietnamese style. There was a big bowl of rice. We would just take some rice, share the dishes. My sons were absolutely going crazy. That's Sunny's brother, by the way. He was the driver. And that was our tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Okay.